And this is very different. This token machine is very different and very unique as compared to whatever you see at other service centers. At other service centers, fully digital electronic system. You don't need to do anything, you just need to punch in your number, say I punch in my number. Right? And I just say continue. I'll basically add my name. I'll say submit. It is already added before, sorry. So maybe I'll need some other number because I tried it this morning. Maybe, why don't you give me your number? And when his turn comes, the number will be called out and he can just go to the support user. Now the interesting thing is to make it available on our app. So we have something called as a MeStore app, which is our shopping app. If you go to the service section, you can actually check. For example, this service center over here, which is in Prashant Nagar, there are two people waiting in the queue. And the average wait time is 10 minutes. While if you go to the service center at Nizampet, there is 0% waiting over there. The average time is 0. So not only you can just come to the service center to take electronic token, you can actually go to our MeStore app and take the goods from there. In order to ensure transparency, we have added the price list of all key components. This price list is over here. This price list is there on our website or our app, me.com. And this price list is also visible on the TV. So now going forward, every single of our service centers will have a TV. And on the TV, we'll show the entire price list. Right? If you look at on the other side of the service center, the back side, it's like last year, Redmi 4 was the second best selling phone. So we said, so we have Redmi 5 and Redmi Note 5 over there. About this board, things like way to escalate in case of facing a problem. Who is the service in charge over here? Who is the area service manager? Who is his boss? Everything is basically mentioned over there. In case people have a problem, they can basically escalate. We have an accessibility zone at every single service center. Here, people who are waiting can basically go through the accessibility, they can look at them. They can also buy accessories if they want from each of our service centers. So, this is basically the whole. Of course, very beautifully designed. As you can see, it's a very minimalist design, completely white background. Customer service officers, they basically sit. So whenever your turn comes, you can basically come and explain what the problem is. These people are fully trained to ensure that our customers get the best experience in case there's a problem. If you look at the latest IMRP report, it basically says the quality of agent that we have is extremely high, of 90 out of 100. Which is exceptionally high. And service engineers at 96 out of 100, which is looking very high. We have a pouch like this here, and all these desks we basically find a pouch like this. Now this is a small pouch, but what we do is every time there is a customer complaint, we basically keep the phone in this pouch. And that's when we basically send the phone inside. This is to ensure the phone basically is fully protected. It doesn't drop, it doesn't get any further scratches the time we receive the phone and then when we repair the phone. And you guys can come inside, we'll show you. So you can basically think of this way right now. Every service center has four key parts. One, the waiting area. Second is where the part area. These are the four key parts of any service center. What it basically means is every phone which comes in, and it comes in these kind of pouches. When the phone comes in, the person sitting here will basically screen and check what is the real problem with the phone. Is it a software repair? And then, if it is a software problem, so people will basically just reflash the software and then it is basically good to be used. Then, if the component has to be replaced, that's what is called as L2 repair. So whether it is motherboard, whether it is camera module, whether it is battery, whether it is anything else, the person sitting here is fully competent to basically repair and replace that particular component. And all these are the same L2 service stations. Now the interesting thing that you will notice is all of these are ESD compliant. So what basically happens is, in order to ensure that there is no electrostatic discharge, which basically happens in the phone, which can cause damage to the phone, each of the person who are sitting over here basically will attach this thing like this and will hear. And this is earth. So any electrostatic discharge is earth, and it prevents the phone from getting damaged. Okay? This is the whole service bit. The service engineers basically set up also well documented. So every service center will have a files like this. Like this is a new one. So all these
different procedures, different instructions, everything is basically sent to our service engineers. And for every process, they will need to sign off and they will need to say that yes, they've read it, they've understood it. And they're like formal coaching and different kind of training sessions held. So this is where all the parts are basically kept. Usually this entire warehouse is, every single service center will have a mini warehouse like this. And this will be like fully occupied. In this particular case, of course, we've just kept few components because today is our inauguration day. But usually this is fully packed. And more than 98% of the times, any complaint that we get, we will have a spare part over here. We have two large warehouses, one in Gurgaon and one in Bangalore. And we have a small warehouse in every single service center. If you look at it, it's very easy to read. You will know which phone it is, what is the part code, and what is the part description. And again, each of these will be ASD compliant, which means basically there cannot be any electrostatic discharge happening to or damaging any of these components.
Hi, my name is Manu Jain. I lead Xiaomi's business in India. Xiaomi is one of the leading internet companies in the world. We have been in India for about 4 years. And for last three quarters, which is Q3 last year, Q4 last year, and Q1 this year, we are now the number one smartphone brand in the country. If you look at the entire country, if there are three smartphones sold today in the country, one out of three is basically a Xiaomi phone, which means Xiaomi overall, including both online and offline, has about 30% plus market share. If you look at the online segment specifically, where we started, we have about 60% market share, and we are 6x bigger than the second biggest brand. In the offline, we started building this business only about a year ago, and we are probably the fastest growing offline brand in the country. And we have already become the second largest brand in the offline segment with about 13-14% market share. So online about 60%, offline about 13-14%, and overall in the country, we have 30% plus market share. And very excited to be here because we believe it's not only important to be the number one selling brand, but also number one loved brand. And to ensure that we are the number one loved brand, today we are taking the next big step and we are inaugurating 1,000 service center here in the beautiful city of Hyderabad. So our philosophy is very simple. We try and provide best specs, highest quality, at an honest price. You mentioned some of the competition brands. I won't talk about any specific competition, but if you look at many of these products, like for example, the kind of product that you were talking about, they're at a very different specs. If we were to launch phones with similar kind of specs, we can probably launch them at under 10,000, what they're selling at 14,000-15,000. For example, one of the phones that was recently launched uses Snapdragon 6 430 processor, which is a two-year-old processor that we were using on a phones less than 7,000 rupee. And this is the processor which is being used on a phone which is 15,000 rupee. So if you really look at most of our products, they have like amazing great specs at an incredible price. Whether it is Redmi Note 5, whether it is Redmi Y2, Redmi Note 5 Pro, any of the products that we recently launched. So I really think this whole business model of having the best specs, highest quality and honest price is something that nobody else is able to match as much as what Xiaomi is able to provide. Xiaomi is actually a lot more than just a smartphone brand. Xiaomi is an internet company and we have a host of other internet services. And we've been launching many other internet services in the country like Mi Music, Mi Video and Mi Credit. I'm happy to share one of our other internet services, Mi Drop, which is basically a file sharing app. We launched this in India about 6 months ago, in end of 2017. And within 6 months, now we have 50 million, which is 5 crore downloads from Google Play organically. And a large number of these downloads are also non-Xiaomi phones, because it is available for any Android user. So we aim to basically launch a lot of such internet services because the eventual aim of the company is to make money from internet services and not make money by selling hardware. We look at hardware as a vehicle to deliver these internet services to our Mi fans. So we have 7-8 categories that we have launched in India till now. We're there in phones, number one. We have fitness band, called as Mi Band. We are number one in the country. We have about 55% market share, which means if there are two fitness or wearable devices sold in the country, one out of two is a Xiaomi device. We have power banks. We again believe we are number one in the country. In three other categories, things like routers, air purifier, smart TV. There are no third-party report, but if you look at just the e-commerce data, we believe we are the number one online selling brand. But we would, of course, want to launch many of these products in the offline segment also. So we just launched our smart TVs, which are probably the smartest TV, and it's the world's thinnest LED TV, Mi TV 455-inch. And we are definitely working to ramp up our supplies and also ensure that we launch them in offline market because we have received a phenomenal response in offline and we would want to replicate something in offline. And we just launched many more lifestyle products. We just launched this t-shirt, the one that I'm wearing, I Love Me t-shirt. We launched pens, pillows and a few other products. And we would want to expand and launch many more products for our Mi fans. Maybe in China we have like 30-40 different categories, in India we only have 7-8. So if you wait for next few years, we will introduce a lot more categories in India that we have in China right now. We have of course filed for it, I won't be able to talk anything more than that right now. So we have a great relationship with Sri City. Our first manufacturing plant in the country was at Sri City, and we've been expanding over there. So if you look at this, our overall manufacturing plants, we have 6 factories in India, managed by our partners Foxconn and HiPat. 5 of them are managed by Foxconn in 2 different plants, one at Sri City, one at Chennai, Sri Perumbudur, and the HiPat plant is in Noida, NCR. Across all our plants, today we can produce more than 2 phones every single second. And that translates into, if you look at the IDC numbers, when IDC says that we're number one for last 3 quarters, about 9 to 10 million phones every single quarter for last 3 quarters. So that's what we are doing. We've also started PCB manufacturing in Sri Perumbudur, Chennai, and which is extremely important because PCB is the costliest component, and that contributes about 40-50% of the value of the phone. And that is something that we have started manufacturing in the country. So in many of the cities, offline cities, we already are either number one, only in offline, or a close number two. And if you include online, of course, we would be number one in most of the cities, right? So we want to expand. Right now, we're present about like 30-40 cities in offline. We want to take it to a few hundred cities, maybe this year or next year. And we want to ensure that everybody, even like tier 2, tier 3, even tier 4, tier 5 in rural areas, if people want to buy Xiaomi phones, they should be able to buy it. But sales is just one part of it, right? The second part of this is how do you service these customers in case they face a problem? If you look at the field failure rate, which is a measure of quality, how great quality your phones are, it basically denotes how many phones come back as a problem. Our field failure rate is the lowest in the industry. It's probably less than half of what the top 5 brands in India are, and which talks about the kind of quality of phones that we have. In addition to this, for these small cities, we're also expanding our service network. So I mentioned that we are opening the 1,000 service center today. Now these 1,000 service centers are present across 600 cities. So even like small tier 2, 3, tier 4 cities are covered through our service network. And again, they get a phenomenal response when they walk into a service center. Today, if first of all, a field failure rate is low, which means a far less number of people get complaints. But even if they get complaints, when they walk into a service center, we ensure that more than 95% of complaints, even in small towns and villages, they get resolved. 95% of complaints get resolved within 4 hours, and 85% get resolved within 2 hours, which we believe is probably the best or one of the best in the industry. And that is why our customer satisfaction scores, which is called a CSAT, is probably the highest in the industry. So just imagine, like, some of these customers are already a little bit unhappy when they walk into a service center, but we are able to convert them, and 86% of the people walk out of a service center feeling extremely happy and positive about our service. So they become happy customers. And this is probably, again, an industry benchmark. So on one hand, in smaller towns, we're expanding our offline business. On the other hand, we're expanding our after-sales service network.